I'm back. Hey, what's up? So we got the approval. Well, we didn't get the approval, but we're gonna go to Pittsburgh on the 8th, and we're gonna go the whole week. I'm so excited. Well, I'm not that excited, but I'm excited to go and get this thing done so we can start getting in the process. So that's what's new. The way it kind of happened was Pittsburgh told my mom just to like come in. And hopefully we'll have the insurance approved. I don't know. I still don't trust it that much. But we're going to go. And we're going to get in. And me and my mom are going to stay at a nice hotel. And the night before. And I'm going to go swimming with my suit and everything. So I'm going to take video of that for you guys. I'm going to take video of the whole ride there. So I'm really excited about that. I like going on road trips because I'm really good at road trips and I like them a lot. Okay, so this video... This is gonna be my cancer video. Yeah. Okay, so transplant 2009. Cancer basically right after. Cancer, I don't remember that much. All I remember was having a lot of morning sickness. Okay. In this video, I'm going to show you guys pictures. I have a bunch of pictures that I will show you, but I'm not going to do it like I did before, the stupid way. I'm actually going to put them into the video by the editing, because I'm getting better at that, so I'm really excited for that. And I want to talk about my friend Marisol, who has been going through everything with me. We had the transplants at the same time, and we had cancer at the same time. We both went through it together, we both survived it together, and we both fought it together. We both won. This time around, hopefully our second transplants, we both go through together. Unfortunately, we both did have rejection. My next video is going to be about rejection, hopefully. Or, you know, the next few videos I will talk about that, because that was one of my biggest struggles I've ever had. And it was very, very, very hard, and I'm still basically dealing with the, what do you call it? I don't know if it's about the consequences. It's more just like the after part, and it just really sucks about having rejection about your transplant. It's one of the risks of the transplant is rejection, and just so happened, it happened to me, it happened to her, it really sucks. So, before I get into the whole cancer thing, Marisol has been with me for a long time now. I feel like we've been like sisters, and we treat like each other like we're sisters. Like, you know. And her family is my second family, and I'm pretty sure it's the same way around. Hopefully she will be in a video with me during next week, because I'm actually seeing her next week, and I'm really excited about that. We're a little different, but it's okay, because we're basically the same person too. So yeah, I really love her. Ingrid, her mom, is like my second mom. It's really funny how our moms actually met. They met in the laundry room when we had our first transplants, and they just started talking, and they were like, it was kind of like, oh, my daughter is going through a transplant. I was like, oh my god, my daughter is too. And then it just so happened, oh, my daughter has cancer. And it was like, oh my god, my daughter does too. And you know, we kind of just exchanged contacts. We kept in touch, so she's like, we're like buddies. And now we have the same doctors and everything, and it's really cool, and I love her so much. So hi Mary, because I know, and her name is Marisol, and yeah, like I said, like, she's like my sister. I love her so much. Okay, anyway, back to the cancer. It wasn't that, since I don't remember a lot of it, I don't really, it doesn't affect me that much, and I always forget that I did have cancer, because it just, like, it doesn't, it, like, to most people, it's like, oh my god, like, she had cancer, and she has to live with cancer for the rest of her life. No, I'm cancer-free. I've been cancer-free for a while now. Once they, hair, I had bandanas, like, how people in Hollywood have shoes. Like, that's literally, like, what my thing was. And then after that, I started loving headbands. And then after headbands, I got my bows. Today, I'm all Harley Quinn down, by the way. Yes, my bow. I have a couple bows of Harley Quinn. And I never thought of it as, oh, this thing can kill me. it was kind of just because I was so little. I was like, I mean, I knew it could, but I never thought of it that way. I was kind of just like, oh, okay, like I have to be in the hospital. I'm going to have to get all this medicines, and I have to get it, you know. And then at one point, I started losing all my hair, and I was like, Mom, why am I losing my hair? And she was like, well, you're going to lose all your hair. She did tell me before, but it was like, you know, when you're little, you forget things. So it was hard, and it was hard for my family, of course, the most, because they knew more about me, but I was just like, I don't know, it was just another battle for me, and it's my other, just another battle wound that I have, you know, and it never actually, and thankfully for me, it never messed with anything to, like, mentally or anything. Like, I get good grades in school, and I'm really, I don't want to sound like this. I don't want to sound like I'm like, oh, I'm this and that. But no, like, it never messed with me. Like, I think it should have. I mean, it probably did a little bit because I am slow with certain things. But, you know, it's whatever. So, and I actually look back and I'm like, wow, like, now that, I mean, obviously now I know about more about cancer and things. And it's kind of just like, wow, I did that, you know. So, yeah, and I was on tons of medicines, obviously, like chemo and all that, and I had a PICC line in for all that, so that was, like, in my arm. I think in one of the pictures, it's in my arm, it was, like, right here. So, I don't have my central line, I have a PICC line, which is, like, the weaker, more stupid version of a central line, so it doesn't stand for.
Can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. It ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side.
And now that's like really it for like cancer. I don't know how to explain it because it really wasn't that, like I said, it wasn't that much to me, but the photos will explain more of what I did. And like I said, like I learned bandanas and everything. And yeah, so all right, that's it for this video. I'm gonna record some more videos, so if I'm wearing the same clothes, don't judge. I don't feel like getting changed, okay, because I've had a long day and I'm tired, so yeah. Okay, bye guys.